Are you wondering how to add unique symbols to your PowerPoint presentation, whether it may be for chemistry, math, or even just symbols in general? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to use everything in the symbols section in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see here on my screen, nice visual of 2 plus 2, you know, that equals 5. Just kidding, equals 4. All right, so you may be wondering where the symbol section is located. So you go here from home to insert, and then symbols right here. All right, so in this section, we have equation and symbol. So equation, I actually did a video on this already, so feel free to check it out right here if you wanna watch that entire in-depth video. And it shows you how to create very custom equations, but basically a quick brief overview of equation is if I hit down this drop-down menu, you're gonna see a bunch of very commonly used equations for whatever it may be that you need an equation for. And then you can click on that equation and then it'll insert it right here. Now it's gonna pop up all these different symbols right here, fraction, script, like all these different structures you can mess around with. And another thing I personally like to do is if you go here to insert equation and then do ink equation, you can actually write your own custom equations. So if I do like 2 plus 2, all right, we're getting real fancy here. X, you know, over 52. Okay, yep. It's a little sloppy, but then let's say you like that equation, you can then insert it, and now you have your custom equation. So unless you see kind of the pre-built equation right here, I would probably just recommend writing it out, or if you're trying to look up a certain equation, Google it and then write it out through that ink equation function right here. It's just a really quick way on how to do that. So another thing too is, let's say you like this equation right here and you want to edit it, you can always insert different things like here or scripts. So just know these are features here as well. All right, so another thing to note is, let's say you got your equation and you want to go here to insert, you want to add in a symbol. So if I click on nothing, you're not going to be able to have this symbol functionality. So you have to have something selected for you to insert a symbol. All right. So even if I have this box and then I type in some letters, then this is going to pop up. Or if I have this selected, this will pop up, but nothing selected, grayed out. So I'm going to select this text box right here and I want to add a symbol, click on symbol. And now, oh my goodness, this opens up a very head-throbbing window of a billion symbols. And you're like, okay, this is too much, you guys. Like, I don't know how, like, this is trying to find a needle in a haystack for what symbol you need. Okay, it's too much. So luckily, they do have these filters for you. So if you're looking for a certain font or a certain type of subset, let's say you're trying to find IPA extensions. I don't even know what that is, to be honest, but let's say you're looking for that. It'll take you to where those might be located. Also, luckily, it will show you where your recently used symbols are down here. So if you are using a lot of frequently used symbols, you can find them down here, and that's how you can easily add in symbols as well. But you may have to do a little bit of hunting, but just know that they do have almost every single known to man in this. A lot of these, I don't even know what they represent, but just know that this is a functionality in PowerPoint if you are trying to add very unique symbols in your PowerPoint presentation. So with that being said, I hope you guys did find this video helpful. And if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning all things about PowerPoint, I do have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.